is on the phone. Hello, Noel Fielding.
Oh, hey. Hi, how are you, Russell?
Oh, I'm really well. You all right, mate?
Yeah, I've got a filthy cold, so I sound a bit like a sort of croaky old div, but I'm all right. Yeah, I'm good.
You sound like a doddery old crow man.
I know, it's wrong, isn't it? Is it sexy, or is it just a bit disturbing? It's a bit disturbing,
well,
isn't it?
In one respect, it's sexy, but it's like, this is the emotion I went through. God, I'd like to give him one, but then I've sort of imagined you on a hospital bed with a drip attached to you, and like that maybe I'd knock over your dialysis machine as I climaxed.
shatter my dialysis machine into tiny fragments.
Did you listen to the answer phone message we left you last week?
It was beautiful, yeah, I loved it, but I haven't got your new number. You did send it to me, and I deleted it by accident, like right at Wazzock.
Why would anyone delete a number by accident?
I couldn't return your call and say, oh, thank you, it was nice. I forgot. I was at a party and I plugged my phone into charger and someone knocked my phone into the sink and I had to put it in the air.
There's no plug by a sink.
Half an hour later, but it was too late by then.
No, that whole story sounded like such a ridiculous contrivance that if it happened in one of your television programmes, people would call it too bizarre.
I know, it's too ridiculous for it not to be true. It did actually happen.
Good
someone
defense.
Nudged it into a sink. Oh, there was some right horrible stuff in there as well. Like an old bowl that had spaghetti in it or something.
Oh, no. The spaghetti floating out. Oh, God, that's horrible.
Oh, it was gross.
No one needs that. Did you hear Guy Pearce, a.k.a. Mike from Neighbours, left
a bit
of
I was quite
message.
Excited, I have to admit. I was a little bit starstruck.
Guess who's coming on later? Uncle Monty. Out of with now and I.
We're going oh, no way, way. Really? Yeah. What's his name? Richard something?
Richard Griffiths. Yeah. Right. We're going to get him to say stuff, you know, out of with
out
now
of
and
the
I.
Film, you're going to get him to say, what does he say?
Oh,
I must have you even if it means burglary. That's my favourite line. Get him to say
right,
that.
All right, that's your request. We'll definitely get that done. How's your festival going, Michael Eavis?
I don't know. I've started wearing a sort of flat cap and I mean, just being no moustache, if that's helped. It's going all right. Yeah, we've got loads of people on it now. The Charlatans are coming. Gary
that's
Newman,
good.
The Kills. We've got El Harmer, superstar.
That's
got
brilliant.
Loads of comedians. We've got Greg Fleet, Tim Key. Oh, Tony Law, they're all coming.
Yeah.
Josie Long.
Oh,
you
brilliant.
Can come.
All right, I'll turn up. Thanks for the invite. You know Noel Gallagher that Tim Burgess out of the Charlatans looks like a little engine driver. He says he's like a little engine driver, red rolls his cheeks.
He
it's
does
nice,
a bit,
though.
Doesn't he? He's got
he looks like
he
a lovely...
hasn't aged ever in the last 20 years.
Do you think that he's made some terrible, terrible pact, Tim Burgess?
Well, I went round his house once and he was just sitting there in the Fountain of Youth. He's got it in his house and he's flat. He's dragged it in. He just sits in it all day. He's got all toys in there, boats and ducks and stuff, but and bubble baths, but it is pretty much, he just sits in there, his little bowl cut, sticking out the top, it's nice.
Does he piddle in for the Fountain of Youth?
I think so, I think that's what, and he sucks his flannel as well, he pulls the flannel out and sucks it.
Oh, it's been a while since I've sucked on a flannel, and I've got to tell you, I miss it.
I miss that, I used to like sucking on a flannel, it's quite good fun, wasn't it, that? It was always a Sunday night for me when I used to suck on flannels. There wasn't time in the rest of the time I should take baths, but Sunday night before school, flannel sucking time.
Little flannel suck, go downstairs, watch the Muppet Show.
Exactly.
Perfect way to round off a weekend, if you ask me. Yeah, thanks for agreeing to do this Focus 12 fundraiser thing on the 27th of July at the Dominion Theatre. Noel, it's very kind of you.
I'm looking forward to it. And as you say, maybe it's good for me to be looking
little
after these charities.
Little pension plan
while I can.
Yeah, it's just like you throwing some money into your own future.
Yeah.
That's what you're doing there.
There's just been far too much too many phones getting nudged into sinks lately.
Too much. Yeah, too much phone mixing.
I'm staying in there. It's a Saturday night and I'm indoors. I just watched the Portugal match. I'm being a good boy for that.
James Corden and Matt Horn are going to do that thing as well. That'd be good, wouldn't it?
Yeah, cool.
Do you see him about? Cause...
I see him about, yeah. He's doing the rounds, isn't he, James? I see him everywhere. Yeah. Everywhere I go. He's
getting
nice
amongst
boy.
It, isn't he? Saucy
yeah,
little sod.
I did see Matt actually as well the other day. He's got very blue eyes, isn't he? Like little
he's
coloured
an handsome.
Christmas lights.
He's an handsome little sod. Sometimes like that bit in Fight Club where Edward Norton beats up that good looking one. I want to do that to Matt Horn out of envy.
He's got eyes, like Christmas eyes. Little Christmas eyes. I know. Embedded in a sort of slightly Mr. Punch face, but not that that's a bad thing. It's a good
like
thing.
A sexy
Mr. Punch.
Yeah, I'll go for him. What do you like about Mr. Punch?
He's sort of wooden cheekbones, and I don't know, I don't really know what's under his garment. His garment, it all looks a bit thin and sort of weird under there, but I imagine he's all sinewy under there.
I reckon there's a lot of sinew, but I don't think he'd treat you well, Noel. So, don't get into a coat. So probably I think you'd be better off with a policeman or the crocodile or any number of the others.
Crocodiles, though, aren't there, in the whole scenario, that sort of insane crocodile who just hits everyone and sort of pukes on things. I like him.
Yeah, the whole bunch, they carry on, they've got a lovely thing going on. Now, what about your band?
There's no reason to that crocodile.
When something's not got a sort of a modus operandi that you can relate to, you think, well, they could do anything. It's like a serial killer. Do you know what I mean?
I know, it's like Planet of the Apes. You couldn't reason with them. It's too frightening. I don't like that. There's no way you wouldn't be able to. There's nothing you could say.
What could you say? Say, hold on.
You down.
Think of your children. They wouldn't care.
It'd mean nothing.
Nothing. There's no way of getting to it.
Primate faces looking back at you blankly as they clamp you to the floor.
Just the cold, indifferent stare, as your own mind suddenly blinks off like a closing old-time TV. Noel, I'm looking forward to seeing you, and it's
and
nice that you're staying
on. Text me your number again so I can ring you.
I will do. A lot of people love your answer phone message, which has been like that for years, and I thought, obviously, so for me now, that was just a normal thing to hear, but when I heard it in the context of the radio show, I thought, well, that's going to affect people's lives.
Did Guy Pearce like it?
Guy Pearce loved it. Guy Pearce, I see him cup himself.
Made my year. Are you still having fun over there?
Yeah, it's all right, mate. There's a lot going on. There's nice, it's good. I think you'd enjoy it. Are you going to come over here, do you think?
I'd love to, yeah. I'd love to come over. We've got, to do a tour there in September, but I'd love to come after that. Let's talk of few things. So maybe, it'd be really nice.
Remember, we were going to make up a film as we went along. That was going to be a lot of fun for everybody.
That'd be good, yeah. Well, I'll come over for that, definitely. You sort it all out for me so that I can just walk in and straight onto set and then in costume. We'll get it going.
I'm an enabler, essentially. I'm going to enable you to continue your lifestyle whilst being successful in films. Noel Fielding, thank you for coming on, mate, and I'll talk to you later.
I'll see you at that gig. Take care, Russell.
See you, mate. Bye-bye. There we go.